two beer nerds, and seven beers. This is Fresh Fest with Guzzle and Frag.
Overall, I gotta say, like, I'm really happy with the variety we had with this pack. Mm-hmm. I know that Tavor was only able to supply seven beers of, mm-hmm. I know there was more than that of the entire festival. Mm-hmm. This is a really cool thing, and I hope more breweries, you know, I mean, I don't want to talk about next year, but if this mm-hmm. goes into next year, then if breweries are wondering what to do, do it online, man. You know, do a virtual fest, release the beers out to everybody, and it's a good way for us to try, like, beers we would have never even heard of, so.
100%, and I think that's kind of the beauty of this time that we are in. You know, as many negatives as we can draw from everything, because, you know, honestly, fuck 2020. Am I right? But, like, where we are at, like, this is kind of the beauty of it, is that we can, like, taste things, once again, from, like, different regions or different places or different collaborations. And I think that is the beauty of it, because prior to this, I don't know that we were going to be able to taste something like this.
I don't
even
think so.
If it is like seven, right?
Yeah. Shout out to Fresh Fest, because they could have just said, oh, well, we can't have everybody get together this year. We're just going to cancel the fest, right? They were like, yeah. No, we're gonna do the fest. It's just going to be online. Mm-hmm. But it's like, you know, for making the beers available, like, in the face of what they had to go up against, you know, it's like, what do we do with our fest, you know? And it's like, yeah, like, I love that attitude of, like, we're going to do it, you know? Like, mm-hmm. we'll figure out a way. And, like, that the perseverance is something to be admired. And, like, mm-hmm. I'm really happy that they did this, because we got to try a lot of really awesome beer that we would have never had. So cheers to you guys for pushing through.
100%.
And we appreciate it.
100%.
And maybe next year, if things are the way they are now, we'll get another batch of delicious beer from you guys and more good
peanut butter beer
collaborations. I think that was also, like, a really interesting aspect of this pack, was every single beer was a collaboration, people working together. Mm-hmm. And these times is what you really need. I think that's a really awesome thing to support. And so we're really happy that we got to do this. And
for sure.
A lot of good beer, man.
Which is the one that you would want to go back to?
Do I have to pick just one?
You know what? Yes. Yeah, absolutely. Like, what is the one at this point that you want right now?
Okay. And
I'm not saying, oh, pick your favorite, but, like, right now, what is the one that you want?
I'll tell you right now, I drink more of this.
Wow. Yeah.
Well, I want more chocolate peanut butter.
Yeah,
what can I say?
That's super duper fair. And I think that, like, it's a harder decision for me, because I feel like between you and I is probably, like, in my opinion, it was probably, like, the best of the batch. Like, we started at the top, right? Like, it's, you know, it's like the whole, like, oh, started from the bottom, now we're here. No. We started here, right? Like, in the way that was, like, really, really a wonderful beer. But, like, this is also really great.
Yeah.
I agree with you there. Or thinking about the dancing gnome.
Yeah. The war cloud.
Yes. Wise words.
Wise words, yeah.
Like, for me, because I do enjoy the hops.
Yeah.
I think it's also that. So it's, like, it's almost like a tie. But I think if we're finishing, we're talking about coming full circle on that graph that we were talking. Like, lager to lager, or, like, pilsner to pilsner, I almost feel like between you and I is what I would almost crave right now.
I don't want to judge any of these beers over the other, but I think they were all really, they all had something to offer.
Yeah, and I think that's, like, the main question. It's not necessarily, like, what do you feel is the best, but I think at this point, like, where we're at, what is the one that you'd want to revisit, like, right now?
Yeah.
Right? And it seems like you just consistently would just want to go with Brewer's Gonna Work It Out, which is...
I'm with you that Green Bench and then the Four Points Pilsner was, I mean, to start off on such a strong beer was a little bit, well, number one, it was unexpected, and then number two,
yes,
a little unfair to the other beers. But, you know, it's like you were saying earlier, that it's like we're kind of in tune about, like, what we like and what we dislike. And so Kent and I are both aligned in terms of Pilsners and, like, what we're looking for in those beers. So that was a very strong beer to open this out on, and we were not really, maybe that was also like we were not expecting it to be what it was. And
oh, so absolutely.
We were kind of blown away, like
triple octed, whatever the terminology.
Decocted, yeah, we had to look that up.
Yes. Like,
what?
I don't even, you had an expectation for it, but like with the, it was super great. Like to start there, I feel like we were absolutely, like 100% we were spoiled.
Yeah. Thanks everybody for watching. I hope this was either educational or entertaining, hopefully both, but maybe you learned something. And hey, you have 14 new breweries to follow and look out for beer from them. If you're in Pennsylvania, a lot of these might be familiar to you, but if you're outside of there, you probably never heard of these because we hadn't either. So,
no. Listen to me, like War Cloud, maybe one day. Like, because it is so, it's on the West Coast for us, right? And it is in like SoCal.
Yeah.
That would be like the closest one. Like,
and War Cloud, I know of them because they are a black owned brewery, and they, there was an article about the Black is Beautiful series, which I've been drinking as many of those beers as I can find. And War Cloud was definitely one of the leaders in the black owned brewery scene, and they're definitely like pushing hard for that. So those guys are awesome. Support what they're doing. Okay. If you live in California, buy their beer, support them. I mean, because we need more diversity and we need more inclusion. And so mm-hmm. this is a really important thing that they're working on. And hey, it turns out their beer is good. So what more reason do you need to support? So go ahead and do that. I want to thank Kent for joining me for this. I bought all these beers sight unseen and I was like, I could just drink them by myself, but what fun is that? And we have Kent here to offer a whole different perspective and like his own notes.
100% fluff.
And kind of expand this into something way more interesting. It was way more interesting to me. Hopefully for you guys, you got a lot out of this too. And I had a great time. So hopefully you all liked it too. And
yeah, I think it was really fun to just be able to nerd out on these beers and just kind of have zero expectation coming in and to just kind of follow this progression through it all. Like whether it was good, and it wasn't ever necessarily bad. I think it's just like, honestly, each and every one of these beers had a lot to offer on the table. And now, sure. Were there some favorites or were there ones that we liked over the other? Absolutely. And you could probably tell that from the video. But at the same time, like it's what's interesting to me is like actually that we're able to break it all down. Right. And or just like shoot the breeze about anything and everything. And I think that's what made this fun.
Like, well, I think, you know, I don't know if it was the goal of the Fresh Beer Fest, but I think right now the kind of driving force behind beer should be unity. Bring everybody together, all backgrounds, all races, everybody. Bring them all together, because if there's one thing you can unite around, it is definitely beer.
Yes.
So everybody unite around beer, like get with your buddies. I mean, I know COVID right now, it's tricky, but try to figure out a safe way to do it.
Yeah. Zoom and talk about beer. It doesn't necessarily
exactly
matter.
Or Discord or whatever. Get on with your buddies and connect with them. I mean, this is a time when hope is really low, so you know people need to really connect and everything. And I think
check on your friends, make sure that they're okay.
I think Fresh Fest, these guys, you know, they get it, and they were like, we're gonna make this happen. It might be virtual, but it's like you can't stop the fest, and I think that's awesome. And we're happy to play just a really, really tiny role in helping that along, but we're really happy to try all the different amazing beers that they were able to get together and make, all the different beers, brewers that they collaborated with. We're excited to see next year what this turns into. Hopefully we can actually...
We'll do it again, man.
Yeah, and if it has to be remote again, so be it. But we will be here, and we can get a whole nother batch of beer and do this all over again and have some really awesome stuff.
Or we're going to force feed this guy like so many IPAs until he actually understands and appreciates maybe more IPAs.
They've been saying, I'll turn over one day, but it's been, man.
It's going to happen.
It's been almost 20 years, and I'll drink an IPA, but I'm not... I'm still not an IPA guy. I don't know.
I'll find one.
Figure it out. Yeah.
I'll figure it out. Yeah.
Hey, don't forget to follow Kent on Instagram. You talk about like palates, man, this guy's got it. Is going to review all kinds of crazy restaurants and really interesting food. So go ahead and follow him.
Listen,
you're going to be entertained. Don't worry.
I like food. I eat a lot. I think that's basically the gist of it. But it's, you know, if you kind of want to see what is generally around this area and what might be new or different or whatever it might be, tune in for sure. It'll be fun.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Link in the description for Kent's Instagram. Mm-hmm. Go follow him. Give him a like his stories and stuff, man. Just support him. And I hope you guys had fun. We had fun, for sure.
Yes.
And we're going to revisit a couple of these, probably. Here's our little list. So, hey, cheers to Fresh Fest. Cheers to Tavor.
Yes.
Cheers to Kent. Cheers to all of you for watching. Thank you. And I hope this was fun.
Yeah.
See you later.
Good night.
We hope you enjoyed our Fresh Fest impressions. Thanks to my buddy Kent for joining up and sharing the beers. Like, subscribe, and let us know what you think. More great beer content's on the way. Cheers.